Good morning, students. In previous lecture, we have studied Heaviside bridge as a part of mutual inductance. Now, today's topic is Campbell's easy bridge. For studying that topic, we have to need first look to the our previous Heaviside bridge, because our Campbell's easy bridge is a kind of modification to the Heaviside bridge. So this is the Heaviside easy bridge diagram. We have L1, R1, mutual inductance M, L2, R2, R3 and R4. We have find the equations of M and R1, and in another way for self inductance, we have find the value of L2 and R2. Now coming to the equations directly. As a unknown mutual inductance, we have find the value of M and along with R1. We have taken another case of self-inductance, measurement of self-inductance, in which we have taken L2 as a self-inductance that is to be determined. So we have find the value of L2 in previous lecture, and R2 is equals to R1 and R4 divided by R3. So to find the equations in our today's lecture, we will need to just focus on this equation L2 and R2. Now coming to the topic, Campbell's modification of a Heaviside bridge. Basically, this bridge is used for the measurement of self-inductance in terms of mutual inductance. We have already discussed that mutual inductance can be used for measurement of self-inductance, capacitance and etc. So this is kind of basic example or application of mutual inductance. In this case, an additional coil L and R is induced in arm AD in series with the inductor which is to be determined. In addition, we have a small resistance R in the arm AB. Now looking that modification to the Heaviside bridge, this is our Campbell's AC bridge. Here we have taken this L and R as a balancing coil. Basically, this L and R will be used in our equation to be reduced, and this small r is used as a variable. We are going to vary our AC bridge by varying the mutual inductance M and this small R1. We will take two cases for finding the equations. First case in which this switch is open, and second case in which the switch is closed. So in this circuit, basically we have add this L and R in series with this L2 and R2 that is to be determined in this Campbell's AC bridge, and we have add this small r in this branch AB. Now coming to the equation, basically two sets of readings are to be taken in this AC bridge. Let the value M and R, in case of switch open, we have taken the value M1 and small R1, and in case of switch is closed, we have taken the value M2 and R2. Now from our previous equation of L2 from the Heaviside bridge, we have L2. In addition, we have taken this L because we have this L in series with L2. So directly we are adding L2 plus L, and which is equals to M1 multiplied by R3 plus R4. In addition, R4 L1 divided by R3. This is our equation directly from Heaviside AC bridge diagram. Okay. This equation is when the switch is open. When the switch is open, we have the whole part as a impedance. Now when the switch is closed, so we will have only our balance coil in the picture. So our L will be equals to M2 in bracket R3 plus R4 addition by R4 L1 divided by R3. Okay, this is the direct equation we have taken from our previous lecture. Now if we subtract this L from this equation 4.38, we will get our L2, which will be equals to L2 is equals to M1 minus M2 multiplied by 1 plus R4 by R3. Okay, so we have find the value of L2, which is to be determined. Now, from our previous lecture, we have our equation R2, that was R2 multiply is equals to R1 R4 divided by R3. But here we have this R in series with this R2. So we have R2 plus R is equals to R1 plus a small r1, that is in series with this capital R1. R1 plus a small r1 multiplied by R4 by R3. Now when the switch is closed, we have only this R in picture instead of this R2. So directly we have R is equals to R1 plus small r2, because in case of switch closed, we have taken a value of small r is equals to R2, small r2. So our capital R is equals to R1 plus R2 multiplied by R4 by R3. By subtracting this value of R, or putting this value of R in this above equation, we can get the value of R2, which is equals to small r1 minus small r2 multiplied by R4 by R3. So we will get the values of L2 and R2, that is to be determined. Okay, if in like previous case, we have taken the case of where R3 is equal to R4 for simplifying the equations. So if we put this R3 is equal to R4 in our equation 4.39 and 4.40, we'll get L2 is equal to 2 times of M1 minus M2, and R2 is equal to small r1 minus R2. Now coming to the Heaviside Campbell equal ratio bridge. Basically, this bridge is also a modification of a Campbell's bridge. It is a better arrangement to improve the sensitivity, and it also get rid of the balancing coil, use of a balancing coil. We have a diagram of Heaviside Campbell equal ratio bridge. In this method, secondary mutual inductor is made up of two equal coils having self inductance. Like we have a mutual inductance divided in two parts. One of the coil is connected in arm AB and other in arm AD. The primary of a mutual inductance reacts with both L2 and R2, which is to be known, which is to be determined by us. Okay, these are unknown values. The resistance of R3 and R4 are made equal. The balance is obtained by varying the mutual inductance, and this is small r, like our in previous case Campbell's bridge. Okay, at a balance condition, we will have our I1 R3 is equals to our I2 R4. Okay, so like we have taken this R3 is equals to R4, so we will have I1 is equals to I2, which is equals to the half of total current coming in this line. So we can also say that I is equals to I1 plus I2, where this I is the total current coming in this line. So we have the equation like this. Now like in Heaviside bridge, we have taken the voltage drop across this ABC equals to ADC, which will be more complicated. So we will just take the voltage drop across this arm AB will equals to this arm AD. So the voltage drop across this arm AB will be equals to I1 multiplied by R1 plus small r plus I1 j omega L, voltage drop across this coil, plus I j W omega MX, which will be equals to I2 R2 plus I to j omega L to plus L minus of I j omega my. Here we can see the coil is in phase apart. Okay, so we have taken this mutual inductance as a negative quantity. So in this equation we have put the value of I1 as I1 by 2 and I2 as I by 2. So cancelling the whole I from whole the equation, we get I1 R is equals to R2 divided by R2 plus j omega L by 2 plus mx is equals to R2 by 2 plus j omega in bracket L2 plus L divided by 2 minus of j omega mx my, sorry. Equating the real and imaginary term, we will get R2 is equals to capital R1 plus R and L2 is equals to 2 times of mx plus my, that is equal to 2 times of mutual inductance. So the magnitude of inductance which can be measured by this method is twice as the mutual inductance we will taking. The value calculated above includes the effect of the leads also. In order to eliminate these effects, we can take two readings with open circuited and closed circuited. As we have taken these kind of values in our Campbell's AC bridge. So for open circuit we have taken M1 and small R1, and for closed circuit we have taken M2 and R2. By putting the values of this and solving the above equation, we will get the equations like R1 is equals to small R1 minus R small R2 and L1 is equals to 2 times of M1 minus M2. So here in this lecture we have studied about our Campbell's AC bridge as a modification of Heaviside bridge, and we have also studied about our second AC bridge, that is Heaviside Campbell equal ratio bridge. In our next lecture we will study about Carey Foster bridge. You can see the topic here also. We will study in the next lecture. Till now study the material, and the notes will be provided to our college website. Any query you can write me. Till then, study and be safe, stay healthy, stay safe.